Hello everyone and welcome to Maple Leaf ESL. My name is Andrew and thank you for joining me here today. For today's lesson, we're going to take a look at how to use swear words, okay? And in this lesson, we're going to look at the swear word bitch, okay? Before we begin, just remember that a lot of these words are considered rude and you should not use them in most situations. In fact, you probably shouldn't use them at all, but if you do use them with your friends, okay? All right, let's see if we can get started. So the first one is a noun and it says they're simply bitch, okay? And we've got three different definitions. The first one says an unpleasant or selfish person, okay? And often a woman, it says there. Okay, so if I say she's being a real bitch, right? That means she's being unpleasant, she's not being nice, I don't like her, essentially. Okay, but if I say this to a woman, that is a really, really big insult. It is incredibly rude, okay? If you ever said that to a woman, expect for her to punch you in the face, okay? Because it's really not nice and you really should not say that, okay? Okay, it doesn't have to be a woman, okay? It says often a woman, but we can say it about a man too. If I say he's a real bitch, again, that just means, you know, he's not a nice person, right? Or maybe he's really selfish, okay? So he's, and again, you can say he's being a bitch, right? Or he is a bitch, okay? And it's really not nice, so I suggest not using it. Okay, next one says a submissive or weak person. Okay, imagine there are two people, okay? Well, we've got John and we've got Bill. Okay, imagine Bill always does everything that John asks him, right? John says, go get me a coffee. So Bill goes and gets him a coffee. And then John says, you know, I'm cold, get my jacket. So Bill goes and gets John's jacket. So in this situation, we could say that Bill is John's bitch, right? Because Bill does everything that John asks of him, right? So Bill is kind of a weak guy. He's sort of submissive, right? Remember, submissive means that you'll sort of obey what another person does, right? So if Bill is always obeying what John does, we can say Bill is John's bitch, right? Okay, and the last one says something that is difficult or not fun. Okay, imagine I'm doing a project, okay? And I'm really not having fun with this project, right? I'm not enjoying it. And also, it's really difficult. So I could say this project is a real bitch, okay? Or imagine I'm trying to fix something, right? Maybe my car broke and I'm trying to fix the engine and I can't do it, okay? And I don't enjoy fixing this engine. So I can say fixing this engine is a real bitch, right? So again, it's not fun, it's not pleasant, okay? Okay, and one more thing about that, often with guys, they can use this in more of like a positive way, right? If I say to my friend, hey, what's up, bitch, right? In this case, it kind of just means, hey, what's up, friend, or how are you doing, friend? So guys will often say that to each other. They'll call each other bitches, but they sort of mean it in a friendly way, right? Okay, next one is a verb, and it says bitch or bitch and moan. And the definition is just to complain, okay? So if somebody is always complaining about stuff, you can say they are always bitching about stuff or they're always bitching and moaning about stuff, okay? If somebody's at the bus stop and they're waiting for the bus and the bus is not coming and they keep complaining about it, you can say they keep bitching about the bus, right? Or they're bitching about the bus not arriving, right? So if somebody's complaining, we can say they are bitching or they are bitching and moaning. Okay, next one is an adjective and it says here bitching, and the definition is very good, awesome, excellent, or cool. Okay, this is kind of an older word. People don't say it as much these days, okay? But when I think of this word, I think about cars, right? Especially older cars. like a Mustang or a Camaro, right? If I see a Mustang and I think it's a really cool car, I might say, that's a bitchin' car, right? That's a bitchin' Mustang. Okay, and I could say it about anything. If there's something that I like, I can say that it's bitchin', okay? And again, it just means that I think it's cool or I think it's awesome. But as I said, it's a little bit older. Okay, next one, another adjective, and it says they're bitchy, and the definition is unpleasant or irritable. Okay, and as we said with bitch that we say often, it's about a woman. Okay, with this phrase too, it's often used to describe a woman. Okay, if a woman is in a bad mood, right? She's acting very unpleasant. You might say she's in a bitchy mood or she's acting bitchy. Okay, but as I said before, it does not have to be a woman, right? If a man is complaining or if he's not happy, he's in a bad mood, we could say he's in a bitchy mood, right? So again, that just means he's in an unpleasant mood or an irritable mood. Remember, an irritable mood is when everything is bothering you, right? All these small little things are making you feel sort of angry, right? So again, a bitchy mood, right? Okay, next one is a noun, and it says son of a bitch. Okay, we got two definitions for this one. The first one says an annoying or nasty person. Okay, imagine there's a guy, right? And he's always really mean to me. Maybe he stole something from me, or maybe he said something bad about me. So I might say that guy is a real son of a bitch, right? Or he's a son of a bitch. Okay, and again, that's an insult, right? It's not a nice thing to say, right? So again, be careful using that one. Okay, and second, it says a remark made when angry or hurt. Okay, imagine I'm holding something heavy and then I drop it on my foot. Okay, ouch, that's gonna really hurt. So if I drop it on my foot, I might go, ah, son of a bitch, right? So again, it's just a way to react to something, right? When you're angry or when you're hurt, right? Or again, imagine I'm watching TV, I'm watching a sports game maybe, okay? And my favorite team, they lose. So I might say, son of a bitch, they lost, right? Or they lost again, son of a bitch. So it's kind of just a remark you make when you're angry or again, when you're in pain, right? When you're hurt, okay? Okay, and then next one is a phrasal verb, and it says there to bitch someone out, all right? And the definition is to reprimand or punish someone loudly. Okay, imagine I'm a student, I'm sitting in class, okay, and the teacher is explaining something, right? The teacher is lecturing. But I'm being kind of rude and I'm talking to my friend in the middle of the class. So the teacher might say, hey, Andrew, stop talking to your friend. I'm trying to teach the class. Would you please cooperate? So the teacher's sort of yelling at me. So I can say the teacher bitched me out, right? So the teacher sort of punished me loudly. And in this case, it was in front of the whole class, right? So again, it might be maybe my girlfriend starts yelling at me in the supermarket. So I can say, my girlfriend bitched me out in the supermarket. So again, she was sort of yelling at me or sort of reprimanding me for doing something wrong. Okay, so that is to bitch someone out. Okay, and last one is another phrasal verb, and it also says bitch out. And we've got two definitions for this one. The first one says to not do something because of fear, okay? So imagine I'm at a swimming pool with all of my friends, okay? And we're gonna jump off this big, tall diving board. Maybe it's about 10 meters high, right? Okay, so we're all jumping off the diving board, but then one friend, he's too scared, right? He doesn't wanna do it. So I might say that this one friend bitched out, right? So he didn't do it. He bitched out of jumping off the diving board, right? So again, just remember, that's something you're only gonna say with your friends, right? You're not gonna say it in polite company. Okay, and last definition is to back out of an agreement. Okay, imagine my friends and I, we all made plans to go camping, okay? Or maybe we made plans to go to a concert, okay? So we've all agreed to do this, right? There's an agreement. Okay, but then one friend, he changes his mind. He's not gonna do this now. So we can say he bitched out of our deal or he bitched out of our agreement. So again, that just means he backed out, right? He changed his mind. He's not gonna do it anymore. So he bitched out. Okay, I want to see if we can erase the whiteboard, and I want to take a look at some written examples using each of these swear words. Okay, let's look at the first example here. So it says, I don't know what her problem is. She's being such a bitch, right? So she's being sort of unpleasant or difficult, right? Okay, next one. Bill does everything John asks. He's totally John's bitch, right? So he's sort of weak and submissive to John, right? Okay, next one, cleaning up after the party was a real bitch, right? So it wasn't fun, right? It was difficult. Okay, next one, will you please stop bitching about everything? It's becoming really annoying, right? So please stop complaining about everything. Okay, next, did you see that bitch in Cadillac? So awesome. Good, right? So like I said there, it's common to use it when talking about cars, especially older cars, right? Okay, next one, watch out for Sandra. She's in a bitchy mood today, right? So she's kind of not, she's in a sort of unpleasant mood, right? Okay, next one, that guy is one mean son of a bitch, right? So that would be how we use that one. Okay, and next one, son of a bitch, that hurt. Okay, and like I said before with my example, if I drop something and it hurts, right, it causes pain, I can say son of a bitch, right? Son of a bitch, that hurt. Okay, a couple more. The teacher bitched me out in front of the whole class for not doing my homework, right? So she kind of yelled at me loudly in front of the whole class. Okay, next one, can you believe Ken bitched out on asking out Barbie, right? So he sort of was too scared to ask out this girl on a date, right? Okay, and last one. I thought we had an agreement. Why are you suddenly bitching out, right? So why are you suddenly changing your mind, right? Or backing out of this agreement? Okay, that is the end of today's lesson. Just remember, when you're using swear words, only use them with your friends, or even better, don't use them at all. Thanks so much for joining me here at Maple Leaf ESL, and we'll see you again next time.